Hello students, in this lecture I will discuss with you summary of the poem When I Consider Life, written by John Dryden. Students, I have already discussed with you the text of this poem, and so today we will do summary of this poem When I Consider Life. This is the image of John Dryden. Let us now discuss summary of the poem. In this poem, the poet looks at life and takes a very dark and pessimistic view of it. In this poem, When I Consider Life, the poet looks at life as it is very dark and pessimistic. Pessimistic means full of sadness. Means, according to the poet, life is very dark and it is full of sadness. He is very pessimistic. He has very negative views about life. He is pained to see the foolishness of human beings. The poet is pained. He feels pain when he observes that human beings are getting foolish. They are foolish when they think that life will be better tomorrow. Life cheats and deceives them. It plays dishonest tricks upon them. Life cheats and deceives them. Deceive also means to cheat someone. According to poet, because he has a very pessimistic view of life, so he thinks that life always cheats the human beings. It plays dishonest tricks upon them. It also becomes dishonest with the human beings. Still, human beings go on hoping against hope. Still, in spite of life deceiving the people, still people go on hoping, go on expecting that their future will be better than their present. They love to be cheated by hope. They do not speak a single word against it. They never speak even a single word against the deception of life. They hope that they will achieve tomorrow what they have failed to achieve today. They always hope that their tomorrow will bring joys for them which they have failed to achieve in their present time. They trust the future which proves worse than the present. The future raises our hopes with the promise of some new joys. The people trust their future, and when the future comes, it proves even more worse than their present time. The future raises our hopes with the promise of some new joys. The future of human beings, of the people, raises their hopes with the promise of bringing more and more joys for them. We are cheated once again by the future. The future proves deceptive and robs us of many of our joys of the present. When we hope for a better future and our future comes, it proves to be more deceptive. It acts as a cheater and it robs us of many of our joys of the present. Means, in hope of our better future, we spoil our present also. We spoil the joys of our present while hoping for the better future. Time once gone cannot be recalled. The pleasures of the past can never come back. In this stanza, in this paragraph, the poet tells us that the time once passed cannot be recalled, that the past, that the time of our past cannot be recalled. We cannot live our life again in our past. The pleasures of the past can never come back. Pleasures means the joys, according to the poet. This joys of our past can never come back in our life, in our lives. But all of us hope to get pleasure in the little life that still remains. We always hope for more and more joys and pleasures in our future. We foolishly hope that the future will be better than our past. We always think that our future will be better, will be bright than our past and present. We hope to enjoy golden pleasures in old age, which we failed to enjoy in the golden period of youth. All the human beings hope to enjoy the golden pleasures when they will be old, when they will be in their old age, which all of them fail to enjoy in the golden period of youth. According to the poet, when we are in our youth, we think that we will enjoy our golden pleasures, or we will enjoy when we will be in our old age, but in vain, but it doesn't come true. The poet is fed up with all false hopes of the future. Golden dreams of the future befool us in our youth. They ruin and destroy us in old age. The poet is fed up with all false hopes of the future. The poet says that he is fed up by hoping for the better future. He thinks that all these hopes about better future are false. Golden dreams of the future befool us in our youth. Befool. Befool means to make someone fool. The poet says that the golden dreams of one's future make fool to him or her in his youth. They ruin and destroy us in old age. According to poet, if we dream for golden pleasures in our youth, all these hopes and dreams destroy us or spoil our life when we are in old age. All these hopes destroy us in our old age. So according to the poet, life is full of darkness and pessimism, and full of life is full of sadness, and human beings are foolish enough to be cheated, or we can say to be deceived by the hope or the expectation of a better future. So he points out, the poet points out, that the people or the human beings are so foolish that they go on hoping against hope, they go on hoping for better future while living in their sad present. So this is the summary of our poem, When I Consider Life. Tomorrow we will continue with our next lecture. Thank you very much.